Give it a couple seconds. Blah, 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 blah. Okay, today we're gonna look at inaccessible and accessible tables. The first table we're going to look at is from a regional rail schedule from SEPTA. And the second table is an RTD schedule that is from RTD. So the first table we're going to look at is the inaccessible table. And we'll start there and then transition over to the second website, which is the accessible table.
Weekday bar to Center City, Philadelphia. Effective January 29th, 2017. Visited link vertical layout bar. Link destination codes bar. Link reverse trip. Table with 15 rows and 1 columns. This table shows schedules for a selection of key stops on the route for Chestnut Hill East Line. Regional rail schedule weekday to Center City, Philadelphia. Stops in their scheduled times are listed in the columns.
So I want to point out that having that description is actually really helpful. So that is a very good thing about this table.
Row 1, column 1, train number dash dash greater.
So train number dash dash greater. So now I am in this table and I'm going to try to navigate this as if it were a table using my table navigation keys.
Row 2, column 1, zone station name. Edge of table. Edge of table. Zone station name. Edge of table. Zone station name.
So when I'm using my table navigation hotkeys, it gets stuck into this cell, which is
edge of table, zone station name.
Zone station name. However, if I use the up and down arrow keys, as if I was just reading a page line by line, it will read what is in this column.
Row 2, train number dash dash greater, zone station name, column 1, 2. Link Chestnut Hill East. Row 3, 2. Link Gravers. Row 4, 2. Link Windmoor. Row 5, 2. Link Mount Airy.
Okay, so those indicate to me that in this column are all of the stop names. So now what I'm going to try to do is go across the row to see the times.
Edge of table. Edge of table. 2. Link Mount Airy.
And again, I'm stuck in this cell because I'm using table navigations. Also, I'm stuck in this cell because this schedule is actually broken down into two separate tables. So we have one table that has all of the stop names going down one column, and then the next table is the table that lists the train number and the times that the train stops at the specific stops. However, since they're both two separate tables, you're not able to navigate stop by stop to see when a train comes because they're two separate tables. So let me try to do that.
Out of table, Chestnut Hill East Line regional rail schedule, heading level 1, weekday bar to center, effective January 12th. Visited link vertical layout bar. Link destination, link reverse trip. Table with 15 rows and 1 columns. This table shows schedules for a selection. Regional rail schedule weekday to Center City, Philadelphia. Listed in the columns. Row 1, column 1, train number dash dash greater. Edge of table. Edge of table. Train number dash dash greater. Zone station name. Row 2, 2. Edge of table. 2, link Chestnut Hill East. Out of table, this table shows schedules for a selection of key stops on the route for Chestnut Hill East Line regional rail schedule weekday to Center City, Philadelphia. Stops in their scheduled times are listed in the columns. Table with 15 rows and 25 columns. This table shows schedules for regional rail schedule weekday to Center City, Philadelphia. Listed in the columns. Row 1, column 1, 705. Column 2, 707.
Okay, so now I'm actually in the table that has the train numbers. So these are the train numbers.
Column 3, 7,413. Column 4, 6,713.
And I'm going to go down this specific column and show you that I can't tell when or which stop these times are associated with.
Row 2, 7, colon, 17 a.m. Row 3, 7, colon, 20 a.m. Row 4, 7, colon, 23 a.m.
So because these are two separate tables, I'm unable to get the information of what state, what stop does this train stop at within these time frames. So these are just a few things that make this table inaccessible. So now we're going to move on to the RTD website and look at a table that is accessible.
Zoom dash pro account. Accept RTD bar route stampede colon CU East Campus document. Link schedules. Route stampede colon CU East Campus. Out of list, heading level 2, select your travel options. Heading level 3, direction of travel. Eastbound currently selected. Link westbound. Heading level 3, day of travel. Weekday currently selected. Heading level 2, weekday. Eastbound schedule. Link route map left paren. PDF right paren. Link print. Link download left paren. PDF right paren. Link demo. Blank. Button select visible stops.
Okay, again, having these options to filter the table is really great. What would make this even better would be if they had an option to filter the table by a specific time. So let's say you wanted to look at the buses that run from 10 a.m. to 11 a.m. only and not the rest of it. There isn't an option in the settings initially that let you do that. However, this table does have buttons which let you hide information before or after the stop you're on. And I will show you that.
Table with 75 rows and 7 columns, row 2, column 1, hide trips before this trip, quote greater button.
So hide trips before this trip. So if I hit that button, it'll hide all the trips before this specific row. And now we're going to navigate this table and I'll show you how accessible it is.
Via root column 2, link STMP. Euclid-18th column 3717A.
So 717 a.m. it stops at Euclid Avenue.
Colorado-28th column 4720A. Innovation-discovery column 5-. Colorado-Monroe column 6723A.
So it stops at Colorado and Monroe at 723 a.m. And I'm using my table navigation keys and I'm not using my up and down arrows. So I'm going to go down to the second row and show you what that looks like.
STMP row 3733A.
733 a.m.
Innovation-discovery column 5-. Colorado-28th column 4730A.
703. So as you can see with this table, it's a lot easier to navigate because it's all of the information is one table rather than being split up into two separate tables, which was a very big problem in the first website we looked at. But this table does not do that, and it makes the information a lot easier to access.